And welcome to another episode of Enigmatica 6 Expert, where in between episodes, I just quickly set up some automation with this. Pretty simple, maybe not the most efficient way to do it. We've got three new channels. These are all like item type channels. So we extract on this channel number two. And what is dying out there? Something standing on the lava, isn't it? Yes, it was. Anyhow, we are extracting on channel number two. And we are extracting only frost steel ingots. And we have a limit of one in the destination inventory, which is this one here. And we have a limit of one here. And this is an insert. Yeah, it seems to work. I don't know if we need both, but it's working at the moment. And then we've got another channel. And this is doing the exact same thing, but with Electrum. So extracting one, like extract a single Electrum ingot and keep a maximum of one in the destination inventory. And, you know, insert into this energizing orb, but keep a maximum of one in the destination inventory. And then the final one, which is extracting from the orb only energized steel and inserting into this chest with no limit. So yeah. Frost steel and Electrum go in this chest. Energized steel go in this chest. And yeah, eventually we end up with stuff. And I'm not sure. Okay, this might be draining. Might be draining more power than we're creating. But like, I reckon it'll probably finish all of this and then have time to charge back up. But sweet. We got a bunch of energized steel. I think we can even use this as like a tetra tool base. Which book is the Akashic Tome? Oh, there. If we look in tetra, I am reasonably sure. Pickaxe head. So this is wood, stone, metal, energized steel. It's a tier of four. We're using what? Netherite. Netherite also is a tier of four. It's actually really difficult to compare these two. Oh no, netherite has a higher tier, so not worth swapping energized steel for that. But we use it in crafting. Now, I've also been just, you know, looking through some quests at what we could be getting into next, and very quickly realizing we're going to need a lot of stuff. So taking a look at what we've got ahead of us in terms of the next tech chapter, nuclear physics, because we're getting close. We need to create concrete, which I've been looking into. We could trade for it. I'll probably instead go for the crafting method, where we can make liquid concrete in a mixer, but we unfortunately cannot assemble one of them yet because we haven't made the blueprint thing that unlocks it. So we'll probably be going the create route. I probably want to set up some sort of cobblestone generator to make sure we've also always got enough gravel, because concrete's kind of cool for building with too. That'll get us that liquid concrete, and we could then press it into concrete blocks. Or you can pour it out on the ground is another way of doing that. And I think you normally get more out of it than doing it this way. So yeah, we do need to do concrete. That's going to lead us into getting the petit machine frames, which is kind of leading into a whole bunch of stuff, like a builder. So potentially a quarry card, right? Potentially a quarry card. No. I'm going to say 1 billion RF. We need flux cores, which needs ender cores, which needs 20 million. Yes, we need spawner cores. Right. So no. So that is kind of gating us. But we've still got the refined storage controller, which people have been mentioning that this is extremely power hungry. Like a a basic, you know, controller. They were saying it uses like 2,000 RF a tick, which we do not have. We do not have 2,000 RF a tick. Not even close. These guys are making 40 each. We could go for upgrades. I don't know if the upgrades have been buffed. Like crafting these integral components. We can make these advanced PCBs now. I wouldn't say super easy, but reasonably easy. And then we could do... There's like an upgrade somewhere. I thought that increases how much power stuff generates. Is it this thing? I thought there was a different one. Increases process speed but reduces RF efficiency. Maybe these can be used. I thought it was a different one actually. So we could go that route to get us some more power. Crafting this, I think the only thing we haven't made is slime steel ingots. Which that was actually really simple. Sky slime we can get from a nearby slime island. I might actually already have a bunch. These raw advanced processors. Again, the only thing we haven't made is Enderium, which I believe also isn't too bad. We do need diamond dust. I've got a few diamonds, but I wouldn't mind actually setting up a pulverizer. Because then we can start pulverizing all of that diamond armor we've been getting from mobs from the mob farm, which has not been running for a long time. And that'll solve our diamond problem. So maybe we work on crafting this controller. And we'll see. We've made all the stuff. We'll see how bad it is on power. It could be pretty bad. And all of that diamond armor and stuff that we got from the spawner. Well, from the mob farm. That's working pretty good. I really hope we end up needing a bunch of diamonds for something, and we should be able to get a decent amount of iron. Oh, can we not pulverize this? Oh. Huh, the induction smelter would work quite well here. But we can't pulverize it. Okay. And ended up whipping up another induction smelter so we could get iron from that armor we've been getting from the mob farm, but had to go with XNet. If you just import from a chest above, we would put multiple in here, which is not a valid recipe, so we had to do like a extract from this but only one and insert in this guy but only one on another channel. So a little bit messy, but still kind of cool. And now we'll get a bunch of iron and potentially gold. Not that the stuff's necessarily too hard to get. There's more iron in here. Like these can be induction smeltered. This gold, that's an induction smelter one as well, not a crusher. So that's cool. And with a bit of crafting, we've got some hardened integral components. And it's the advanced PCBs we're out of, which... We're missing plastic sheets. Which shouldn't be too bad, actually. Now we've got a bunch. So put this on, bucket mode. Actually, I should be careful with that because I'm picking if they overlap, you don't get anything out of them. So we'll... Like if you dump like a bucket of water onto a water source, you normally lose the bucket of water. Might be the same with plastic. And I'm interested to see what sort of a power boost we get. Let's start with just one. Can we make one of these things? We need lead gears. Actually a little bit short on lead. We should be able to craft some gears. That's already got the gear thing in there. Lead's pretty quick. Let's grab these two. I was crafting iron gears earlier. I buff this in here and here. Let's just start with one upgrade. Because I'm not entirely convinced this is the correct one. I think this is the one that makes machines go faster. So, yeah, if we put... Oh, this doesn't even go in there. Cool, so... Oh, okay, so this is the one that makes that go faster, and then that would make it go even faster. I probably don't want to do that. I need to find the one of these that is making maximum power. He's making 40. 80. So doubles the power output. Which if the 2000 RF attack... oh, we can stack multiple of them. That's right. But yeah, if refined storage actually does use 2000 RF attack, that's going to be rough. Yeah, there must not be an augment that just improves power. I really thought there was. Aha! I thought there was a way to increase the power generation of a dynamo. Nice. I was actually looking into, I think, two, maybe three episodes back, I said we could make lithium, and you need brine for that, which you can get from the refinery that we're using to process oil. So water turns into brine and heaps of steam, which I don't know what I'd be doing with the steam. And that brine could then go in another refinery and make liquid lithium and more steam, which I don't know what we're going to do with that either. And then that lithium could go in the thermopneumatic processing plant. And that would give us lithium dust. It's weird that it... Why is it like negative? Maybe negative means it runs better? I don't know, but we could get lithium dust if we needed to. And that was for making reinforced alloy. Which was for making... maybe it was diamond backpacks. I don't remember. Anyhow, back to what I was doing. I'll probably try make one of these. I doubt we have the stuff, though. Silver gear. That's not too bad. This should be making 160 RF attack now. If we were using it, but I've processed all the stuff I needed to process. So, cool. Should be good in the future, though. I've also ran basic universal cable all the way over to the other building, so everything is now powered by our blaze tower of power, which is neat. And some advanced processors, and oh no, too much time on a bottle. And this will get us the machine frames. I really need to work on another one of these things because I am using a lot of time in a bottle. This is 2.5 bar. We're going to need some extra pressure in there. Once we get this machine casing, slime cylinders, that was easy. Vacuum tubes we haven't made, but they're not bad at all. Yeah, we'll almost be there. And this might be the last thing. So I just made a bunch of vacuum tubes because I'm sure they're used in other things. And worst case scenario, we never use them. You know, they're used for other things. Probably going to want a portal controller. May want garden closures. Let's not look at that right now, but... Chuck these in here. I need two of them. And that is going to be the last ingredient we need for the controller. What are the cables like? Oh. Okay. So there are going to be some other things we need to make. We've made pipes, mineral resin... And we can use arboreal extractors. We probably will. We need to get some mineral trees. We need to melt down some redstone. That should get us logic cables. And then they are used The stuff which isn't too bad. Annoying to make more than anything. So that might be one of the the first things we look at automating. Once we get like the refined storage controllers, but we might have power issues before then. So I think that's everything. And this is going to quite satisfyingly combine everything into our refined storage controller. Although it looks like we're still a little ways away from really being able to take advantage of it. I might set this up over here. We're going to need a bigger base for like all the factory stuff we really need to be making, so we might start expanding out this way. But hey. He went into the chest. Hoo-hoo, refined storage. Oh, that's a big moment. Do we get... Oh, that's a bit of stuff. I was really hoping for like some cables as a reward, but no. Oh, we got a reinforced chest. Well, I'm sure that will be handy for something. But nice. That's cool. Let's go, I guess, plug this in. I don't know where it's going to live full time. Let's just... So by itself, it's using 256 RF attack. That's a lot for doing nothing. And the more things we hook onto that, the more it's gonna take to run it. Wow, it's almost completely drained. So wait, they hold 1 million RF. This holds 10 million RF. Neat. I do like having an excuse to get some power generation going, but yeah, 160. I guess two of these, the two upgraded ones, are actually going to be providing enough for this guy. Just probably transfer through these cables isn't the best. Do you retain your power? You do, thank goodness. Let's let you drain that guy as well. But neat. Refined storage. Whew. Yeah, I think being able to make cables is going to be one of the next things we need. We also need, I guess like the crafting grid would be good. Which needs a grid. Lucky I made like four of these machine casings. Okay, we need Petunia stuff. That's right, I need to make Lumium. Oh, this is like, Ichor honeycomb. An Ichor bee. A skilled tinkerer can use their smeltery for casting more than mere tool parts. Liquid Ichor bee. Liquid slimy bee and blood. Liquid slimy bee is a slimy bee. Okay. That's rough. But we might want a bit of that. But yeah. Hey, this guy's looking... Looking semi-powered. Let's let you drain that energy cell as well. Refined storage. Almost. Not quite. We've still got a bit of work to do before we can actually use this, but I think next episode we need to set up cable production. At least, you know, extracting the fluid from the trees and stuff. Okay, it's been ClassicDuff. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.